Good morning to everybody on this Thursday of the first week of our September training school. Great to welcome everybody here this morning, and we've been very blessed with the school so far. So I'm just going to start by reading from Isaiah, an awesome passage in Isaiah 45. You know, God is the eternal God. He is amazing, isn't he? And no matter what is happening around about us, God changes not. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And this is what Isaiah says about him. For thus says Yahweh, who created the heavens, who is God, who formed the earth and made it, who established it, who did not create it in vain, who formed it to be inhabited. I, Yahweh, there is no other. I have not spoken in secret in a dark place of the earth. I did not say to the seeds of Jacob, seek me in vain. I, Yahweh, speak righteousness. I declare things that are right. Assemble yourselves and come, draw near together, you who have escaped from the nations. They have no knowledge, who carry the wood or their carved image and pray to a God that cannot save. Tell and bring forth your case. Yes, let them take counsel together who have declared this from ancient time. Who has told it from the beginning? Have not I, Yahweh? There is no other God beside me, a just God and a Saviour. There is none beside me. Look to me and be saved, all you ends of the earth. For I am God and there is no other. I have sworn by myself. The word has gone out of my mouth in righteousness and shall not return, that to me every knee shall bow and every tongue shall take an oath. Hallelujah. So praise God. This is the awesomeness of our God. And we offer ourselves to you this morning as living sacrifices that would be holy and acceptable to you. We thank you for this privilege we have of joining together in your name, and to worship you, to receive from you, and we receive of your Spirit today to guide us, to lead us, to anoint us, to be all that you have purposed that we can be. And we thank you, Lord Jesus, for your presence with us. Amen. So now we're going to invite Rhoda to come and lead us in some worship.
So, my brethren, we are here as true worshippers.
Yes, amen.
Who worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. So let's stand together and begin with Hallelujah. These are the days of Elijah. And I know the word that's going to flow forth out of this time of worship is to do with the spirit and power of Elijah, the days of restoration we are in.
Amen.
Amen. And we are worshiping our Father. Hallelujah.
These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And these are the days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sore.
Still
we are the voice in the desert crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice. It's a year of jubilee, and out of Zion's hill salvation comes.
These are the days of Ezekiel.
Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest.
Hallelujah.
The fields are as white in the world.
earth.
These are the days of Messiah, His rule and His reign in the earth. And these are the days of His Son's arising, creation is being restored. These are days of great evil, the wicked they rage against Christ. Still we are the voice of the risen Messiah, glory is filling the earth. Behold, He comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, at the trumpet call.
This is the day of freedom. This is the day of sons of God knowing their place in the Father's house. Hallelujah. His voice is being heard. And Jesus, we thank You for Your Spirit among us, filling us. God, bringing us deeper and deeper into You, Jesus. Hallelujah. Sing, Spirit of the Living God, awakening our hearts. Thank You, Jesus.
Spirit of the Living God, awakening our hearts for the risen Messiah, He reigns. Spirit of the Living God, Spirit of the Living God, breathing upon our lives, for You've called us to be the sons of God. Spirit of the Living God, Spirit of the Living God, awakening our hearts for the risen Messiah, He reigns. Spirit of the Living God, Spirit of the Living God, breathing upon our lives, for You've called us to be the sons of God, all of creation. Such a time as this, for such a time as this, You were born, for such a time as this, for such a time as this, You were born, for such a time as this, for such a time as this, You were born. Such a time as this, we were born. Such a time as this, we were born. All of creation, and all of creation rejoices. Rejoices in this home.
Spirit of the living God. Spirit of the living God. Awakening our hearts for the reason Messiah you raised. Jesus. Spirit of the living God. Breathing upon our lives, for you've called us to be the sons of God. Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus, in every nation, we thank you that you are calling forth your sons from every direction, the ends of the earth, those whom you've created for your glory,
Amen.
For your purpose, for such a time as this.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord, we want to lift up prayers. So we want to come into it just a time of prayer. Just a reminder that this Saturday we're having a special time of prayer here from 11 till 1, and it's to call our nation back to God. So let's, as the sons of God, begin to even cry out now for our nation. This nation needs Jesus. This nation needs to have a turning back to Him because of the unrighteousness that is happening everywhere, because of the ungodliness and the deceit and the lies and the deception that are coming out of the mouths even of our premiers and our leaders. So let's just everyone begin crying out to God, and let's have some prayer for this nation, and then as we feel led, pray out a prayer for this nation. We'll bring the mic to you. Hallelujah. I know Iva has a big heart for this nation. Would you like to pray for us?
Loving Heavenly Father, we come to you, and our prayer is for this nation of Australia, that Prince Nation you called it. And we just thank you, Lord, that you have good people there at the leadership, and we pray for them to have wisdom for what to do and what to say, and call this whole nation back to you. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
As we were singing, my eyes caught on the fact that I've got one of my grandson's name here on the 12th of the 2nd, 2017, which says, "Look to me and be saved, all you ends of the earth, for I am God and there is no other. I have sworn by myself, the word has gone out of my mouth in righteousness, and it shall not return, that to me every knee shall bow and every tongue shall take an oath, and he shall say, surely in the Lord I have righteousness and strength. To him men shall come, and all shall be ashamed who are incensed against him. In the Lord and all the descendants of Israel shall be justified and shall glory." I just want to thank you, Lord, that you promised for each one of my children. And they're special to me, but to each mother here who has children that are outside of your kingdom, the promise is the same. All the ends of the earth shall be saved. And we glorify you, Lord Jesus, because you are God. There is no else, none else. You are God. To whom shall we come? You have the words of eternal life. We bless your name, Jesus. We worship you. You are God Most High.
One of our brothers in the nations, Maxwell Sayenda from Mozambique. Well, he's from Malawi, but he's a missionary in Mozambique. He had a dream just the other night, two nights ago. And he shared it with me, and this is what it says. This is the dream. He said, "In the dream, I was in a big field or a farm, and it was big, and I couldn't see the end of it. I couldn't see where it ends. And the field was full of fruit trees, apples, oranges, and other fruits, but all of the fruits were ready to harvest, and all were ripe and mature. And suddenly I was no longer alone in the field. I saw a huge group of people, and I could tell who the people were because I was able to mention their names in the dream. And we were all together as a team, and every one of us had big baskets to put the fruits where we were about to be harvesting. And what amazed me was that the people I saw there were the same people we've been together with on the Shiloh Zoom classes. I could see all the faces of the people from Australia, Africa, Asia, black, white, all the people were in that group, and everyone with a basket, and all of us were so excited and happy to be doing the harvesting work. There were some of the trees which were very tall, and while we were thinking on how to pick the fruits that were far and high, I saw one who was called John. He was an orderly person, but white and from Australia. He put on the tall sticks to stand with, and he was able to pick those from which were far. I saw the straights. I saw Papa Paul, Mama Janet, the brethren from Nigeria, Kenya, Australia. It was a huge group from different nations, but we were all in one place harvesting in the field. In the dream, it was so real and happening. The voice which everyone was saying was, "It is time, it is time, it is time," all shouting it while we were working. And then I woke up. He said, "Everyone I know on the Zoom meeting was there, and it was so real. And I woke up while all of us were shouting, saying, 'It is time, it is time, it is time.'" I wanted to share with you as well. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So I want us to pray out of that, because we're entering a season of harvest according to that dream. Amen. So that even in the midst of everything going on, there's a harvest ready to be reaped, and all of us carrying big baskets to pick the fruit. Hallelujah. And so, Father, we thank you that, God, there has been a number of workers raised up for this harvest. But Lord, we know we need to pray for more. But God, we thank you for the excitement and the positivity of that dream. The God, that there was a big farm, there's lots of fruit, but there were a bunch of workers ready to go out into that field and to pick the fruit. And even where there was fruit that was hard to pick, there was still the ability to do it. Hallelujah. And Father, we bring this before you. Lord, we thank you for the way you've led us through this whole season of 2020. Yes. God, we thank you for opening up those Zoom classes. God, we thank you that that's been from the hand of the Lord. That's been from you. God, this more regular discipleship training contact with the saints in the nations. And Father, we lift before you the great harvest. And God, we thank you, Lord. Open our eyes to see the harvest. Open our hearts to see the harvest that is right in front of us, Lord. God, thank you for that word coming through the dream. It is time. It is time. It is time. It is time. Hallelujah. It is time. Everyone say, "It is time."
It is time.
It is time. It is time. Hallelujah. So God, thank you for the promise that when there's deep darkness covering the peoples, the glory of the eternal God Yahweh rises upon us.
Yes.
Lord, enabling us to do the work. And so Father, right now, even in this place, and for those who are going to be seeing this recording, Father, we pray throughout all the nations. Lord, we pray for all of those nations that even represented on Zoom, these classes we've been having. But God, we thank you for the harvest that is in every nation. We thank you that you've been raising us up as a company to work in this harvest, to be sent out into this harvest. And brethren, it is time. It's time to get busy in the work of the harvest. It's time to be giving ourselves to the work of the harvest. Lord, thank you that in that dream there was excitement among the brethren, that the harvest was ready and we could go out into it. Hallelujah. And so God, may you open our eyes, even everyone here, of the harvest field that's around us. And Lord, to see individually but also corporately as a company how God is sending us into this harvest. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for ripe fruit. Thank you for maturity coming forth. God, thank you for this harvest and preparing us for this harvest. In Jesus' name.
Yes,
hallelujah. Amen.
For such a time as this, we were born. For such a time as this, we were born. For such a time as this. For such a time as this, we were born. For such a time as this. For such a time as this, we were born. For such a time as this. For such a time as this, we were born. All of creation is rejoicing. All of creation rejoices.
Oh yeah. Let's sing it again, Rhoda, as we come to the table. Beth, would you like to come and help me? And thank you, Diane. Wonderful to know our place. We are the children of God. We are the sons of God through faith in Jesus Christ. It's wonderful to be in beautiful moments like this to just lay hold of your own soul. Possess your own soul, Jesus said. He said, possess it by patience, in fact. By patience, possess your own soul. Tell your soul, bless the Lord, bless the eternal God, O my soul. Lean not on your own understanding, but give your soul over to God today. Hallelujah. Step up. Just say to God, I no longer want to be bound by my own thoughts, by my own thinking, my own feelings, my stinking thinking, my feelings that I don't have to have anymore. I can just say no. I'm no longer like that. I'm not insecure. I'm not worried. I'm trusting Yahweh, our Father. You know, I was thinking during the worship time how the church historically has been robbed of God's name. The name Yahweh, or some people like to say Jehovah, the majority of believers worldwide for millennium have not known God's name. The last 400 years of history before Jesus came on the earth, the people of God who were the Jews, they did not know God's name. That's when they started calling him Adonai, which is not a name. It refers to an office. And the office is Lord. Because they would not say his name. So they started calling him Lord, which is Hebrew Adonai. And another tradition they built up was they just called him Hashem, the name. But they wouldn't say the name. And there's all this silly controversy down through the ages. Oh, we don't really know how to pronounce the name, so we'll call him Lord. And so generations of believers have not known God's name. Thankfully, some of us got to know the name of Jesus. And then eventually in our own lives, we got to know the name of Yahweh, which appears over 6,500 times and not translated in most Bibles. in the English language. Hallelujah. But how beautiful. We Yahweh is our Father. He's the Father of creation. And so just for a fleeting moment today, just present your life to the Father in Jesus' name. Just thank God that you can offer your life. According to Romans 12, verse 1, you can offer your life as a living sacrifice, your whole body. And the Bible says, you are holy. How's it go? Present yourselves to God as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable. Wow. Say, God accepts me.
God accepts.
Isn't that amazing? God accepts me. I'm one of his saints. I'm one of his holy ones. Hallelujah. 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 And our Father has put a cry in our heart for this nation. Our Father has put a cry in our heart for the 25 million plus souls who call Australia home today. Hallelujah. Now the Bible tells us that God pre-purposed the history of nations and the boundaries of nations. God did it. Man didn't do it. You know, you get people having great discussions about, you know, whether we invaded Australia as white people, whatever you did. But that's not the point. The point is that here we are today in God's purpose, set apart as a nation called Australia for God. It's God's will.
Yeah.
I can only say I find myself as an Australian in the will of God. I didn't have anything to say in it. I could have been born in Uganda. I could have been born in Russia, in Ireland, where my great-grandfathers came from. Could have been born in Latin America. Boy, that'd be scary. But isn't it awesome? We can't help where we're born. We can't help the colour of our skin. We can do nothing about it. You know, some of the dear lady folk in some of the Asian nations, they rub this white sort of stuff on their cheeks every day. Somehow or other they think that'll make them look white, because somehow or other they haven't yet known the acceptance of the Father. That he loves them just as they are. And he has a purpose. So then we're going to eat and drink, and then Faye and I are going to try and sing a song for you. So let's remember Jesus, Yahweh our Father, manifested in the flesh. Okay. You'll have to wait and find out. We asked for Australia. Janet?
She's not.
No, she's ignoring me. We asked for Australia. No?
We ask for Australia. We call her by name. We commend her to the Father in Jesus' name. We ask for Australia. We call her by name. We present her to the Father in Jesus' name. May she not be found naked. May she not be ashamed. We commend her to the Father in Jesus' name. We ask for Australia. Oh, we call her by name. We present her to the Father in Jesus' name. Jesus' name. May she not be found naked. May she not be ashamed. We ask for a stranger in Jesus' name. Lord, we cry out for Australia. Lord, may those that have heard your voice go out and be partakers of the harvest. Oh, Lord Jesus, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name.
Yes. Hallelujah. Good on you. Energized by the Holy Spirit. I just want to tell you, I want to tell you a story. When I was saved in 1974, in June, I think it was, the Prime Minister of Australia was a man called Gough Whitlam, now late. And when Gough Whitlam got elected in 72, I was relieved because I was actually an illegal citizen because I'd refused to register for the military draft, which was fighting in Vietnam at the time. And when you didn't register, you could be arrested and put in jail. So I used to keep moving along, changing addresses, and But I don't know what month it was in 72, but there was an election, and for the first time since 1947, the Labor Party won the federal election. Big historic changes, and their leader was an amazing guy called Gough Whitlam. But Gough Whitlam was an anti-Christ person. He despised God. He hated the Queensland Premier, who was a God-fearing man, etc., etc. But when he first got elected, I was happy because I was released from, because the first decision he announced was that we were pulling out of Vietnam War and that draft dodgers would no longer be illegal citizens. So that was a relief on that hand. But then I got born again in 74. And then in 75, I don't know the date, but a word went around the churches in Australia, we need to fast and pray for the federal government because this Prime Minister is starting to act like a crazy man. He was much more sophisticated than Premier Andrews in Victoria, but he was much more open than Andrew. Andrews is a very hidden sort of a leader, a bit like the North Korea leader, but just comes out occasionally with big announcements and locking everyone down. But anyway, I don't know the details, but Whitlam was starting to act like a dictator, and he's starting to propose things that the nation became afraid of. So call went out for fasting and praying. I was a very young Christian, and I was working in a hard, labouring job every day, but I did my best to join in with that. You know, within 2 weeks of that call to fast and pray, you know what happened? Whitlam got sacked. Something happened in Australia that we'd never dreamed of and could not happen again, but God designed at the time that the Governor-General, who was a perpetual drunk, in one of his sober moments, sacked the Prime Minister. Never heard of. And then he went back to being a drunk. But God used Sir John Kerr to save the nation from socialism and all the other terrible things that Whitlam was going to bring in as the Labor Prime Minister. I tell you that story to encourage you. And a couple of days after that sacking, and you know, this left-wing lady came to my home. She'd been a friend before I was saved, and anyway, she's saying, you know, isn't it terrible? You know, the government's been sacked. Isn't this terrible? And I'm thinking to myself, if only you knew, lady, I'm one of the people responsible for it. I kept quiet. But I saw God answering the prayers of his saints. I want to say that to you because we so much care in this ministry for the nation and to pray to God and see God's hand delivering us. But that's one of the most mighty deliverances I've ever seen in my life, praying for the nation, praying for the country, and look what God did.
Amen.
Amen. So let's finish with this wonderful older chorus, you'll know. We worship you, Almighty God. There is none like you. And to encourage you that as the people of God in this nation, we are now the righteousness of God in Christ. Isn't that awesome? there is a people who are now in this nation, the righteousness of God. So we worship him, and let's give him that praise as we finish this time of worship together.
We worship you, Almighty God. There is none like you. We worship you, O Prince of Peace. That is what we long to do. We give you praise, for you are our righteousness. We worship you,
finish this time, I want to invite you to pray. Paul put out that history of what happened in that amazing period of time. Only a couple of years ago, the church fasted and prayed, and Scott Morrison became the Prime Minister of Australia at the election. And no matter what you think about Scott Morrison's job that he's doing, imagine if it was the other guy who was in. In other words, God's delivered us. Amen. And so we're in another period of time. It just continues. I would say ever since 2013, I think it was, where we got involved with Rise Up Australia parties to a degree and put our candidates and were praying into that. Ever since that time, there's been an increased intensity to be praying for the nation. There's been a huge battle. That saw Tony Abbott get toppled by Malcolm Turnbull. But then, praise God, that God brought in Scott Morrison. Thank you, Jesus. So, Father, we're lifting up the nation to you right now. And I encourage you, if you have a prayer, just raise your hand to let me know. Lord, we're lifting up Australia right now. God, with all these different forces at play, premiers taking it on themselves to rule their states in contradiction to the federal authority. And Father, we're crying out to you for this nation of Australia. God, we cry out to you for Australia. God, we pray for righteousness, Lord. We thank you that when the enemy is coming in, the Spirit of Yahweh raises up a standard against him. And God, we thank you for that awesome standard, that Spirit of the living God raising up a standard in this nation. God, we thank you that things have been halted, things have been stopped to some degree, but Lord, we're praying for the complete turning back in the mighty name of Jesus. The push to begin to turn back that whole tide that's been going for decades. And Father, we thank you for the righteousness of God that comes through faith in Jesus Christ. We thank you, God, that nothing can stop you when you're moving and when you're walking through. And so, Jesus, we invite you into this nation again. We invite you to come into this nation and to intervene in Australia. King of glory, we welcome you. King of glory, we welcome you. Lift up your heads, O you gates. Be lifted up, you everlasting doors of Australia, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? He's Yahweh of armies, strong and mighty. Hallelujah. He's the eternal God of his hosts, his armies, who leads us in battle, mighty in battle. Thank you, Jesus. Come in, Lord Jesus. Come in, King of glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Diane, I'll ask you to pray.
You're faithful, God. You're mighty. You're the one saving us. You're so faithful to this nation. We see your hand on us. We acknowledge you, your mighty strength. No enemy can win. The victory, the healing waters flow from deep within. You have your way, Almighty God. You are mighty to save. We trust you, we know you, we have the victory. We watch you as we win.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One final thing. There's some of you who know what's who see some of the things going on in the world, especially the States. You see that there was a Supreme Court justice that passed away, and now Trump's got the ability to nominate a new one. And the Republican Party in the Senate are saying we've got the votes to do it as well. So they're suggesting they're gonna do this. And it's likely it's gonna be a lady who's gonna be pro-life, pro the Second Amendment of the US Constitution. But to understand something of the significance of this major push that's hit the world, of this left-wing, fanatical, communistic type of destroy the family, destroy everything that's right, promote homosexuality, promote abortion, began in 1973 with a vengeance through the Roe versus Wade decision of the Supreme Court in the US. That's like their foundational victory battle that they got, that gave them even more encouragement to keep marching through all the institutions. That was like the beginning point. And that's why they're manifesting so much right now about this nomination, because they know that that victory of Roe versus Wade that they got is under threat. But I'm just sharing this with you just for us to pray, because if that thing gets taken down, that's like a huge altar. That's a huge idol that gets destroyed if that thing gets taken down. That's a huge power base for them. That'll demoralize them in like a huge way, because that's where that was like the guts of where they started to realize we can take over through doing these sorts of things, through unelected ways. And so, Father, it's just an amazing season we're in. And God, you've raised up this guy called Donald Trump, such an interesting character. And yet you've raised him up at this time. And Father, we pray right now for what's happening in the US. And God, we pray over this whole area of the Supreme Court, and that even there will be the courage to take that idol down. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. That God, it's a funny thing that happens. Even some people start out with some, quote, conservative views, but when they get into the positions, they get all weak. But God, we cry out to you for that idol of Roe versus Wade to get taken down in Jesus' name. And Father, we pray that that will be that rallying cry for your people to go marching through for the kingdom of God in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for the United States because it does have so much influence over the world, that God, we pray for this idol to be smashed. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Amen.